Feeling like I wanted to do it again or start doing something, and I thought what a great idea to be able to get hold of my old buddies in Toronto, way back in the days when we did a lot of live performances and stuff, the Marco Lucianis, the Jerry Mosbys, and I thought we'd be able to get everybody together again and try to capture some magic. So I wanted to relive it a little bit. They went down there and started doing some recording, and that would have been November 2019. And by the time I had it pretty much together, in thinking that there wasn't some ideas that I thought would be usable. Through the beginning of 2020, I had it all done, and then into COVID, which, surprise, surprise. But for the most part, I worked on all the lyrics and solidified everything through the first part of 2020. I usually start with the chord structure and the melodic content of the songs. They seem to come across like colors sometimes and which way they want to go. And then the lyrics are the icing on the cake, so to speak. So music, melody, structure, lyric. Saved is not a religious song. Spent a lot of years being very afraid, doing an awful lot of drinking and carrying on. To come through all that and knowing that what you've been able to do it with is the love of a very very small amount of people that are around you, your children and whatnot, to be able to know that when you have those moments or you're fearing you just can't take it all anymore, to be able to come down to a feeling of peace and to know that you're happy where you are is to be saved. Being able to find peace without having to chase it half across the world, like climb up to the mountain and see who's up there to be able to tell what is the meaning of life. Being happy, finding happiness, being completely comfortable within yourself is to save yourself. Probably took all these years to be able to come to this particular conclusion to make me feel that I am happy where I am. I am saved. It's pretty much something that I think everybody strives for. Words Unspoken, big old love song. How can you deny a love song? For me to be able to feel the depth of a song like Unspoken is to really think about babies, you know, to be able to think about holding this little teeny thing that's swaddled in your arms. And to know that when you're looking at this is completely unspoken love and this deep, deep, deep love for someone so small, for so teeny, so helpless. Wonderful to be able to think that you can take that on to in through your life, and to know that your partner or someone that you're with could feel that same thing, where you have an unspoken thing about you, to be able to know that love and caring. And it's the only thing that I can compare it to, is the innocence of it all. That's what Unspoken means to me. It's we could just look and say, like, you know, ain't nothing better. I love you to death, you know. Would you see in my eyes? Luck of the draw. I love the structure that my friend Silvio Pupo, he's from Cuba, and he had written the song. He was put these chords together, and I listened to it, and I wrote the English lyric for it. Because it was in Spanish, I thought I'd do a lot of songs in Italian, and I figured it can't be that much different. My father spent a lot of time in Venezuela after the war. My stepmother, Flora, was from Ecuador. Then I'm dealing with Silvio Pupo out of Cuba. There seemed to be quite a bit of a Spanish influence all around. So there was no real indication that I was doing this specifically for the record. It was an afterthought. When I read that what he had written in Spanish, I thought it'd be quite interesting for me to give it a shot and see if I could phonetically put it together, because I haven't got a clue what the hell I'm saying. Well, I know it's yet again about love. Well, I really think that anything that I'm writing about, anything that I write, whatever the songs are, I think everybody in particular probably could sort of draw from that. I don't think they're like, you know, these incredible conceptual, like wonderful ideas that nobody's ever thought of before. I think everybody feels them. Everybody's feeling the exact same things that I do. I'm just hoping to be able to find the words or something to let everybody know that I'm with you, you know, you're not alone in feeling these things. It's all about ourselves anyhow, right? If one person feels it, you're pretty sure that someone's gonna feel it too.